Hey there. For our final episode, we are at the Majestic Theater in Madison, Wisconsin. We have loaded our show file up and we have a few issues. No big deal, easy to solve. First thing is, we had planned our show to have Solo Wash 19s. As we find out that we don't have them here, we have Mac 101s, no big deal, we're gonna do a change type. Change type is super simple. We're gonna select our fixtures, 101 through 116, enter. Now change type, just drag my window over here, find our Martin folder, there we are. Mac 101, okay. We've got our Mac 101s loaded in, now we just need to patch them. Bring them up, see? There they are, awesome. Now we need to patch a couple other things. One, we have a mirror ball. Who doesn't love mirror balls? Mirror ball was given to us at address of 15. So we'll select the fixture at 15. We also have blinders. That's address 33. So 15 at 33. Test those. There they are. In addition to our mirror ball and our audience lights, we've also added a fog machine, as you can see on stage. Because we have these extra items, I went ahead and added a MiniWing 4 to our Hedgehog, giving us 10 additional playbacks. We've put a lot of these single items on faders. Our fog machine, for example, our audience lights, and also includes our intensity cues that we made in the earlier episodes. Let's continue talking about how we have our control system set up. We have our MiniWing 4, we have our Hedgehog 4, and we've got our external touchscreen. I'm using the external touchscreen for a lot of cue playback. We recorded a lot of cues directly into the cue list directory. We talked about having guard turned off, and now I can simply go ahead and select these cue lists directly from the cue list directory. One thing we knew we'd have to do coming in here is update some positions. For example, this band position. To update the position is simple. You select the lights that you want to use. I'm gonna go ahead and open up my programmer for this. Move it over. Select the fixtures and move them. And then when we're satisfied with our positions, we select the fixtures again. And I'm gonna go ahead and merge that position into the old one. That's it, now it's saved. I've got a few more positions to update, but I'm gonna wait for the band to be here to get them dialed in. Now let's take a look at some of the effects we made and see if they still work. Looks good. You know what, I think that one looks a little fast now that we're here. I'll go ahead and slow it down and resave that. Think that's better. Just merge, new effect, and done. Let's take a look at some of our colors. See if we still like what we recorded. Not loving this. Let's change this up a little bit. Let's go with that. And we're gonna re-record that list. Record list 8, Q1, enter, and merge it. Let's take a look at our cue list directory, since we're gonna be using that to fire a lot of our cues today. I've matched the color coding to the color coding in the group directory. As you can see, the yellow is our color source pars, so I can sit and click, knowing that they're only gonna be the pars. The washes are in the white, so I can click those knowing that I'm only selecting those. This allows me to very quickly access what I want to grab without accidentally grabbing anything else or having to hunt for it. It's really easy to color code your buttons. If you've got a mouse connected, you simply right click on it and choose your color. If you don't have a mouse, you press the square, hold down pig, press set, and do the same thing. Well, it looks like the band's all set up. We got our positions updated. They're about to sound check. I'm just gonna play through some things over the top of that and see what works. Well, that's a wrap of season one of Learn Hog 4. Thanks for watching and learning. Stay tuned for what we got coming up. Remember, you can download the materials and follow along.